All right, so the Loudness Wars really came to a head in 2008. That's when consumers started to say, hey, this isn't right. And they did so because this one album came out from Metallica called Death Magnetic. And it sounded kind of crappy but loud, but and consumers were kind of used to that, although this is overly loud. But what happened is that they released the Guitar Hero version at the same time, and all of a sudden people realized that the video game version of the songs on Death Magnetic sounded way better than the CD they released in 2008. And so there was a backlash. You know, people were posting videos saying, why does this Guitar Hero version sound better than the album version? And there's a lot of blame that got thrown around. But let's listen and hear what's going on. So you'll hear the just excessive distortion. Just sounds really, really, really bad. So here is just a chunk of Death Magnetic. You can just see it just looks like a big, you know, rectangle here. What the LUFS on this is.
Sunshine never comes.
Now, one of the things you'll get from that is that it sounds very constricting. To me, when I want to hear something that's super limited, I just feel like an internal stress. I don't know if that's something that's just me, but there's an uneasiness I get when there's just this complete lack of dynamics in there, because nothing in the real world is like that. Now, consequently, released that same year, 2008, was Guns N' Roses, almost 20 year follow-up to their previous record, Chinese Democracy. And you can see that one up here is a lot different. Axl Rose actually asked the mastering engineer, Bob Ludwig, to master it like it was the 1980s. And so you get a much different loudness level. So the Metallica's got an LUFS of maybe about minus 5-ish. 4.5, somewhere around there. Let's see where the Guns N' Roses sits. So the drums sound great, but when I A-B back and forth, you know, the Metallica is much louder. If I brought it down like the streaming services would, so maybe I'll bring it down another 6.5 dB, and we'll A-B the two, and then kind of compare how the drums sound. I mean, they're different mixes, obviously, but you'll get an idea here. Guns N' Roses up the top here. So there's a huge difference. The drums in the Guns N' Roses version sounds better. The Metallica version actually caught so much heat that when they re-released it on iTunes in 2015, they remastered it for iTunes. So I grabbed that version. And let's compare the two, the remastered version and the original version. So this is the original version, this is the remastered version. So go back and forth, just loudness-wise. Let's see where this left one is the original, and the right one is the remastered version.
Born to push you around, better just stay.
So let me, so just listening to that with that volume corrected there, the drums sound a lot less distorted, even this is quiet section here.
Born to push you around. Better just stay.
So listen to that kick drum. You hear a big difference in that kick drum and the snare drum there. Let's go to a louder part of the song. Wow, that remastered 2015 version sounds way better. That's what it should have been. And thankfully, that's what the Loudness Wars sort of ending, hopefully, has forced us into accepting stuff that sounds great because there's nothing that the record companies can do to make their stuff sound louder on Spotify or Apple Music or YouTube. So that's the Metallica versus Guns N' Roses thing, which kind of brought it to the public's forefront.